G'day all, Mr. Paladin here, and I'm with Apollo, and we're going to go over a tricky subject that every spy has as to what is a trickstab, and the underlying questions of how to trickstab, when do they work, you know, yada yada, that kind of stuff. So first, let's have a look at our nemesis here, our enemy. Backstabs used to be just directly at the back, but now there's a bit more leniency with Team Fortress 2, where you can go from about this angle over here, on the right side, all the way to about this angle here on this side. So that's a very generous back. This allows you to do quite a few things in the way of trick stabs, and we're going to go over each one. So why do trick stabs work, and why do they work so often when you'd think they wouldn't? It's because this enemy right here can get predictable if you can do a few things to him. For one, they are going to want to go a certain path leaving their spawn. Or, once they see you, especially the pyros, they are going to want you dead. And pyro's most effective weapon being his flamethrower, he wants you dead at about this range. So he's going to keep running at you about this distance. That leads us to be able to lead him to where we want his back to be. The first stab we're going to look at is the most natural stab, and it's probably the stab that you've come across without even thinking about it. It's called a side stab. What happens is the enemy is going to be running along a particular path. You're going to be on a disguise that they believe, or they believe for at least as long as you need the stab to happen. You pass them on their right, and they pass on your right, because before we showed how close that knife came to their side. And as you go past them, you turn and stab. Just real quick flick of the wrist, quick stab, and you've got it. Let's see it in practice. Okay, so let's look at this section of the map. The enemy is going to be coming out of their spawn door. They're probably not thinking spy yet. Spy hasn't entered their head yet. I'm going back to their spawn as an engineer with a wrench. It's not good that I'm using Apollo's name here because he's the only one working with me. But just say for the sake of example, I'm an engineer with a wrench. I'm coming back to spawn looking for metal, and he's going to come out any second. Oh dear. Another example, let's say they're going to be running that path straight out of their spawn. I've got a medic disguise, and I'm going to act distressed, just to try and help convince of the disguise. And that's all it takes, just that brief moment. Another of the trick stabs where the enemy is believing you is what I call the reverse corner. What I'm doing is I'm going to predict that the enemy is going to go up and around a corner. So let's look at a situation that's plausible. I'm a heavy, I'm at about half health, there's a medic there. He's wanting to find a buddy to team up with, so... Ooh, he has full Uber. He's gonna think we're going to the top. I allow him to take that short path around that corner, and then as we get here, he's already thinking about what he's seeing out here. He's not thinking about the fact that I stopped. I face the corner and I give the stab. This can happen in a few places. The reverse corner does not have to be done at the top of the stairs either. We'll look at an example where a scout is believing a pyro disguise. He's gonna come out of spawn. And I can just use the knowledge that he is gonna turn that corner, and I can just stay right here where his back's gonna be. Okay, I could be at the top of this hill here, sniping. Everyone believes I'm a sniper up here. Poor engineer wants to move his stuff. I know he's going to take this short corner. I don't have to be behind him. I'll just make them get in front of me.
Fire! Fire! Fire!
Okay, so let's say, for example, I'm up here, I'm a pyro, I'm defending, I'm calling medic, but an enemy pyro comes out, he doesn't believe the disguise for a second. And you catch him on the corner. It's a blind corner, so he doesn't see that I shift direction. So, what's the theory behind corner stabs working? This guy here, he doesn't believe me, or I've lost my disguise, or I'm expecting him to chase me at a really close range. Either he's melee weapon or he's on a flamethrower, and I'm expecting him to get in real close. I'm wanting to lead him to a corner, and when he can't see me, I'm changing direction and I'm hitting him right here. He's exposed his back to me, and he's had no time to react because he's been in the blind because I've been around the corner that he could not see. Now the main trick with this one is this is actually about the fourth place I could have done the corner stab. The first place would have been around this first corner here, if I had come here and I derped him around there. Next one is around this corner here, he's going to want to chase me and I cornered him there. Then I could have got him right here as he first came around that corner. Then we had what we showed. Then the next one is up here as he comes up to the top. Next one's here as he turns this corner. Next one here as he turns this corner. And if you're really desperate, right in here, but I wouldn't recommend going that far. The enemy has captured our intelligence.
Control point is being contested.
Okay, so we'll look at why stair stabs work and what is a stair stab. Now the essence of stair stab is you're using a stair or an inclined surface to go over the enemy without colliding into their hitbox because you can't pass through enemies and you're wanting to get to their back. The best way to do this is as you jump, you want to get to here but you want to be crouched because when you're standing, you're not going to get the back. But if you're crouched during your jump, even if you collide with their player model, you're going to get the backstab. And this backstab can range anywhere from over this side, just like we had the back before, to over this side. So you don't have to turn 180. You can turn about 90 and still get that stab. So you have any situation where they're coming up the stairs, you turn, you stab. Whether or not you collide with their hitbox or not, if you don't crouch, you're also likely to slide straight off of them. So this one here, this hill is a little bit telegraphed. He can see it's coming. And the stab is a little bit obvious. So what you want to do is more blind stabs. And what blind is an incline where he can't see it coming. You're jumping and you're going to be out of his field of view, and we'll show this from the other perspective. Okay, so this is what I mean by telegraphing. Look at it from the pyro's perspective. I can see him there all the way. I can see him go up. If I have half a clue what's happening, I should be able to avoid that because it just leads to them having reaction time. So in order to do it blind, the best way to do it is to do an air strafe as you jump. And Apollo will do a couple of air strafes here. So you can see he leaves the platform and comes back. This is even safer because, you know, you're not going to get hit. But let's look at it as I come up as a pyro. I could not see that. I saw a flash of him on my screen. So there's a mad pyro chasing you here. Barely a glimpse. Barely a glimpse. Okay, so you can do a stair stab from any inclined surface. Like, take this little bump here, this inconspicuous little bump. So long as I can get on top of Apollo's head, and you see if I drop my ringer here, I'm at his backstab. Right? This can happen off anything. Off this rock. You know, I could get on his head, off his dispenser. You know, anything that will let me go from... let me see, is there a little bump here? Nope, where's a little bump? Come back over here. So anything that will let me get into this position where I'm crouched on his head. Okay, so let's say you come up to this situation. The engineer, he's not backstabbable. But we're going to use his sentry gun. And he's going to be drawn into it for the backstab. Stair stab, incline stab, whatever you want to call it. Yeah, no coming back for you, you stupid, half-witted Texan. Look, he's happy about it, too. Or like this situation, you know, Blue's attacking, we've got a teleporter near Alpha, I'm shooting towards a spawn, some sneaky spy, I've got no Thompson. What a devilish rogue. Off the teleporter. Next we're going to talk about the understab, and this is what happens if you can get someone to chase you off an edge. It's the same kind of situation that's almost the opposite of a stair stab, where their body is going to be above yours. And by adjusting the 180 and being where their feet are going to be, you can get a stab on them. So if you'll excuse this position, the theory behind it is they're coming down, okay, they're going to collide with your body, but if you turn the 180, you get the full backstab even when it was just on their feet. So you can easily bait them into it. If they don't air strafe in the air, you know, most people just fall down normally, it's kind of easy to predict. Okay, so from the reverse angle, this pyro doesn't believe me, I'm disguised as him, he's gonna chase me. He's gonna check me down all day. No problem. By positioning his model to land on my head, I'm going to have access to his feet. Okay, so you can actually use the understab to counter an enemy stair stab. Because you know he's going to be jumping, spinning, and landing, you can stop your forward motion earlier and predict where his feet are going to be. You don't really want him on your head, though, because he's still going to have the opportunity for his strike. You want him landing in front of you. So the next stab we're going to look at is the Matador, and what the Matador is when the enemy knows I'm a spy, he either doesn't believe my disguise, he's chasing me, or I'm just exposed. I'm going to want to go one way so that he sees it in his field of view, and most likely he's going to turn towards me and face me, but just after doing that, I juke the other way and I turn my view, so I suddenly have my knife up. I like to do this juke to the right then the left, because as we saw before, if I slowly go around his player model here, My knife becomes ready right at about where his hand hits his weapon there. So when it actually happens, you juke, juke, stab. You've got to get that twist in to make sure that your knife goes where his back is. And this can happen if he's coming at you or if he's standing still. It's easier if they're coming at you because they want to chase you down. And you see, I looked a little to the left and he juked to the right.
Our control point is being captured. The control point is being captured.
So why don't trick stabs work? Well, if you start doing them all the time, a lot of the trick stabs depend on the enemy being able to see you, and once they see you, they can predict what you're gonna do. So what do you want to do? If you want to dominate the pyros, you're gonna have to start going to your pistol. Give up on that trick stab. They're probably not gonna want to continue chasing you, because chasing you is gonna involve another trick stab. So go to your pistol. Go to your revolver. Knock it out. In conclusion, go ahead and use trick stabs. Don't overuse them. Learn to avoid the spies who do overuse them. And do remember that I'm always a big fan of, if you can get away, go ahead and get away, because the paranoia that you cause to the enemy teams and them looking for you and them wondering if they got you or not is usually sometimes better than getting the kill on them anyway. If you can tie up a couple of enemies trying to hunt you down and being unsuccessful, that's better than the single trick. I have additional spy tutorials in the comments section. Thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors.